Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have put together some questions related to the topic finding number of electrons, protons and neutrons. For links to other topics and question timestamps, please visit video description. Question 31, in which ions are the number of electrons equal to the number of neutrons? We can find electrons by looking at the charge. Proton number is 9, the charge is minus 1, so addition of 1 electron takes place. So 9 plus 1, it becomes 10 electrons. Number of neutrons can be found by subtracting the mass number from atomic number. 19 minus 9, it becomes 10 neutrons. Similarly, in phosphorus, we have negative 1 charge, so 15 protons plus 1 electron, it becomes 16 electrons. And 31 minus 15 becomes 16 neutrons. Part 3, we have sodium positive, so 1 electron is lost, 11 minus 1 will become 10 electrons. 23 minus 11 gives 12 neutrons. As electrons and neutrons are equal in first and second one, therefore answer is B.
Question number 1, what number of protons, neutrons and electrons are present in the ion Fe plus 3? Now the atomic number is not given, so we will be consulting periodic table. So from the periodic table we come to know that the atomic number is 26. Mass number is 54. So the number of protons is 26. Number of electrons, as the charge is plus 3, so it means 3 electrons are lost, so it is 26 minus 3 equals 23 electrons. And neutrons, for neutrons we have to subtract mass number and atomic number. 54 minus 26, the answer comes to be 28. So now it means that the answer is A.
Question 31. The symbol for phosphorus ion is P, negative 3, 33, 15. The symbol of potassium ion is also given. What do these two ions have in common? Number 1, the same number of electrons, then we have neutrons, then protons. Let's find electrons. In phosphorus, we have 15 electrons already present and the negative charge is 3. So 3 electrons are added, so total number of electrons will be 18. In potassium, we can see that we had 19 protons, so there were 19 electrons and 1 electron is lost as the charge is positive. So number of electrons left is also 18. So 1 is correct. 2 is the number of neutrons. Now number of neutrons can be formed by subtracting mass number with atomic number. So we have 18 neutrons for phosphorus. Similarly, we have 18 neutrons for potassium. So 2 is also correct. 3 is the number of protons. As in phosphorus, we have 15 protons. And in potassium, we have 19 protons. So 3 is wrong. As both 1 and 2 are correct, so therefore answer is B. Question number 31, an atom of calcium 48 can form a 2 positive ion. Which statements about this ion are correct? The atomic mass of calcium is given, it is 48. So we can write 48. From periodic table, we know that the atomic number of calcium is 20. So the number of protons is equal to 20. While the number of neutrons is equal to mass number minus atomic number. As the charge is given as 2 positive, so therefore 2 electrons are lost. So the number of electron is 20 minus 2 equals 18. Option 1, it has 20 protons. This is correct. Option 2, it has 28 neutrons. This is also correct. Option 3, it has 22 electrons. This is wrong. The answer is therefore B. Question 32, which statements about an atom of technetium 99 are correct? The atomic number of technetium 99 from periodic table is 43 and the nucleon number is 99. Part 1, it has 13 fewer protons than neutrons. Now protons are 43 and neutrons will be 99 minus 43, 56 neutrons. If we add 13 and 43, it becomes 56, so therefore 1 is correct. Second option, it forms technetium plus 2, which has 45 electrons. Now in neutral technetium, we have 43 electrons. When it becomes plus 2 charge, it means 2 electrons are removed, so it must have 41 electrons instead of 45, so therefore this is wrong. 3. It has 56 nucleons. As we can see in the symbol, we have 99 nucleon numbers, so therefore it is not 56, it is 99. So 3 is also incorrect. So only correct option is 1, so therefore the answer is D. Question 31, which deductions about bismuth 209-83 atom are correct? Number 1, it has 83 electrons. As we can see, the atomic number is 83 and there is no charge. So there must be 83 electrons as there are 83 protons. Number 2, it has 126 nucleons. As we can see that the nucleon number is 209. So therefore 2 is wrong. Number 3, it has 83 neutrons. Now neutrons can be obtained by subtracting nucleon number from atomic number. So it will be 209 minus 83, which is equal to 126. So 3 is also incorrect. As only option 1 is correct, the answer is therefore D. Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.